first of all, be very, if you like, very careful regarding who you decide to call your guru. It's very important, because if you find somebody who is blind himself, he's not going to take you anywhere. He's blind himself, he's going to lead you into the blind alley. So be very, if you like, careful regarding who you decide to call your guru or whose message you want to follow. Be very careful. That's my first health warning. Don't rush. There are so many people promoting themselves and, you know, selling you also gimmicks. Be very careful. At the same time, let me also pass a gentle message. If your own capacity is very limited, suppose you are only interested in razzmatazz, external showmanship, then you'll find a guru who gives you all the razzmatazz. But that is your level. So you found your guru. That's good for you. Carry on. If you like somebody who just kind of, you know, doing all this magic and miracle, you'll find a guru like that. Good for you. That's your level. So we are not vilifying any guru. We're simply saying you will find your level. When you're very serious about religion, you will not be easily bought out by these externals. And you'll search for a guru or a person who is actually enlightened. And we are spoiled for choice. I'm not just promoting what Swami Vivekananda. When we see people like, you know, Ramana Maharshi, modern person, personality, they are talking about religion from experience. You can see there is no make-believe, there's no nonsense, there's no gimmick, they're not selling anything, they're not selling themselves even. So when you come across such genuine personalities, you are in safe, if you like, safe place. But the second part of his question is touching, very touching. Really speaking, have the confidence in yourself to realize that you are going to make spiritual progress suited to your own temperament. You are the best guide. Because spirituality doesn't come from outside, doesn't come from a guru either. They're just indicators. They just kind of stir you up. The real stirring comes from within. So recognizing the dignity which is within, and emphasizing that I will find my way. So be it. Ramana Maharshi didn't have a guru. His guru was a mountain, Arunachal. So like that, you find, if you like, if you are serious about spirituality, this is again a beautiful thing in Hinduism. When you are ready for spiritual progress, you will come across the right personalities or the right ideas that will stir you up. But the stirring always comes from within. It's never from outside. The guru doesn't give that to you. It's within you, but he just stirs you up. He can wax you up. So they're catalysts only. They're just catalysts. They're signposts. But the Hindus have got a problem. Instead of using them as signposts, they just grab them and grab their feet. I'm going to hang on to your feet and sort me out. You sort yourself out. It's a beautiful example I'm using. If you go outside and you see a sign, Wembley Stadium, and you say, Wembley Stadium, and you grab all the signposts and you sit there, you will never go to Wembley Stadium. That is a signpost. The guru is a signpost. Never just grab his feet and sit there, because your progress has stopped then. It is within. You grow in your stature and recognize the divinity which is within you. That is the heart of Hindu teaching.